Hello and welcome to our another video of Scientifically Simple. Our aim is to provide scientific detail in most simple and understandable manner. In this video, we would be talking about developmental biology. And we would be covering various topics like what is development in whole, the common terms regarding developmental biology, fertilization, and the various embryonic stages in the development, which include zygote, cleavage formation, morula, blastula, and gastrulation. Now, let's begin. What is development? Development is a lifelong process. It starts with the zygote and up to a death of an individual. Every organism starts with a single cell and ends up on a multicellular organism level. The study of this growing process is known as developmental biology. In developmental biology, there have been series of production of gametes, fertilization, development of embryo, and emergence of an adult to death. Hans Spemann was the founder of modern developmental biology, and this development consists of various steps, which is the growth, differentiation, and morphogenesis. As we can see, it begins with gametogenesis and then again ends in a circular format for the beginning of a new life from gametogenesis, including fertilization, cleavage, gastrulation, organogenesis, and various larval stages to maturity of an adult, and then again beginning with gametogenesis. Before starting, let's go through some common terms used in developmental biology. First is embryology. It is the study of animal development and the phases that occur between fertilization and birth. Larva is used to denote a younger animal. The germ cell is the gamete and the precursor cell for the gametes. Gametogenesis is the development of a gamete, and this process doesn't occur in an organism which is not physically fit or an adult. Apoptosis is a highly regulated form of programmed cell death that occurs in multicellular organism, and the differentiation is the process by which less specialized cell undergo maturation to form more distinct and have a function for development. Redifferentiation is a process by which once the differentiated cells again return back to their original specialized form. And dedifferentiation is once this dedifferentiated cells revert to their earlier development stages. Let's talk about fertilization. Fertilization is a process by which two gametes, that is the sperm and the egg, fuse together to create a new individual with genetics potential from both the parents. There are four main events which occur in fertilization, that is the contact between sperm and egg, regulating entry into sperm into egg from sperm, and the fusion of genetic material of the sperm and the egg, and activation of egg metabolism to start the development. The gametes of both sperm and egg have a very good structure defined. Sperm consists of an haploid nucleus, a propulsion system, that is a tail, and a sac of enzymes that help it to enter the egg, that is the acrosome. Egg consists of all the necessary material for the beginning of growth and development. Let's talk about spermatogenesis, or the formation of sperm in the primordial germ cells in male testes. During this process, the haploid becomes very streamlined and the DNA is tightly compressed, and this compressed haploid nucleus lies behind the acrosomal vesicle. This acrosome is derived from Golgi apparatus and consists highly enzymes that digest proteins and complex sugars. The role of this acrosome is help the sperm enter into egg. A region of globular actin molecule lies between the nucleus and acrosome vesicle. These proteins are used to extend finger-like acrosome process for the sperm during the early stages of fertilization. As we can see, this is the structure of the sperm, which includes a head, a mid-connecting piece, and a tail. The acrosome surrounds the nucleus, and which is followed by a centriole and mitochondria for providing energy for the movement of the axial filament or the tail. The spermatogenesis starts from a 2N spermatogonium in the male testes and then undergoes mitosis to form a primary spermatocyte and a spermatogonium. The primary spermatocyte is then undergoes meiosis 1 to produce haploid secondary spermatocytes, and then they again undergo meiosis 2 to form a 4 spermatids, and these spermatids undergo spermatogenesis to have a sperm structure. In oogenesis, it is the formation of female gametes, and it takes place in the female reproductive system for the formation of the primary egg cell or the ovum. Oogenesis starts from the oogonium and to form a primary oocyte, and this primary oocyte then forms the first polar body and a secondary oocyte. The secondary oocyte again goes through a meiosis, and then it forms an ovum. The ovum then enters the fallopian tube, and the remaining follicle or the graafian follicle converts to an early corpus luteum, which is known to secrete various hormones in females. Now, there is a formation of zygote once the sperm and the egg unites. The zygote begins with a single cell, but divides rapidly after fertilization. The zygote divides through a process known as mitosis, in which the early cell divides and doubles into two cells. In human zygote, the stages of development occur during first day in a week on following of fertilization. When two haploid cells join, they form a single diploid cell that contain a total of 46 chromosomes, 23 from the parents, from the male, and 23 from the female. The zygote then travels down to the fallopian tube to the uterus, where it must implant in the lining of the uterus to obtain nourishment, as it needs to grow and survive. As you can see, both the eggs and sperm fuse together to form zygote and have both the genetic information from the parents, the male and the female. After fertilization, the development of multicellular organism is proceeded by formation of cleavage. Cleavage is a mitotic division which occurs when after fertilization, and it divides the cell into numerous smaller nucleated cells. These cleavage state cells are called as blastomere. The egg first divides into a half, then quarters, then eight, and so forth. This division occurs at a very fast rate. For example, in a frog, there can be up to 37,000 cells in just 43 hours. The ratio of cytoplasmic content to nuclear volume gets increasingly smaller as the cleavage processes. This is because the overall size remains the same and the nucleus content increases. This ratio is crucial for the activation of certain genes because they are dependent on the decrease in the cytoplasmic content. Because when the cytoplasmic content decreases, the cell gets a signal to increase its volume and begin the activation of the genes which are necessary for the growth and development of the zygote. Thus, cleavage begins soon after fertilization and ends shortly after the stage when embryo achieves a balance between its nucleus and the cytoplasm. As we can see, in day 1 there is a zygote formation. At day 2, the first cleavage occurs and forms the 2 cell stage. As you can notice in this structure, the cell size remains the same, but the amount of nucleus increases with the time. A 4 cell stage and then an 8 cell stage, after which a morula and blastulocyte is formed. Blastulocyte consists of tropoblast, a fluid cavity, and an inner cell mass at day 5. Blastula is a hollow sphere of cell formed after morula. The cells of blastula form an epithelial layer called the blastoderm, which is filled with a cavity or the blastocele. During blastular polarity, cell specification and axis formation helps to regulate the gene expression event over their lifetime. For example, in Xenopus, blastomere have and behave as a pluripotent stem cell which can migrate down to several paths depending on the cell signaling. The cells in the blastula arrange themselves in 2 layers, the inner cell mass and the outer layer, which is the tropoblast. The inner cell mass is known as the embryoblast, and the mass of cell will go further to form the embryo. Morula is an early stage before the blastula and is the 16 cell stage, and after it is formed after the zygote has gone various cell division stages to form cleavages. Gastrulation is the process after blastula which and is a position containing various cells and new neighbors. There are three germ layers which formed in the blastula, which is the ectoderm, which is the outer layer, the inner endoderm, and the interstitial mesoderm are first produced during gastrulation. The cells that will form the endoderm and the mesoderm organs are brought inside. The cells which will form the skin and the nervous system are spread out in the outer surface. Gastrulation usually involves combination of various types of cell movements, which is invagination, involution, ingression, delamination, and epiboly. Let's talk about all of these with pictorial representation. As you can see, invagination is the folding of the cell. In this chair, the cell layer enters and folds inward to the embryo. It is an example commonly seen in sea urchins' endoderm. Involution. In this, the outer layer of the cell surface covers the inner layer and forms the second sheet over the outer layer, and it is normally seen in amphibians of mesoderm. Ingression is the process in which individual cells from the outer layer enter the blastocoele cavity, and it is an example seen in the sea urchin's mesoderm and Drosophila's neuroblast. Delamination is the process in which the single outer layer sheet splits into two sheets for formation of a two-sheet layer structure, and it is commonly seen in mammalians and bird hypoblast formation. The epiboly is the expansion of one sheet layer over the other cell. In this, the outer layer grows a new layer around itself, and to form the outer layer, this is seen in the ectoderm formation of amphibians and sea urchin and tunicates. This is all for this video. I hope you enjoyed and got detailed explanation about the development of biology. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Scientifically Simple. We will be waiting for your comments in the comment section below. You could also mail us at scientificallysimple1@gmail.com. Thank you and have a nice day.